The government under which Jesus lived was corrupt and oppressive. Everywhere were terrible abuses, extortion, intolerance, and grinding cruelty. Yet the Savior attempted no civil reforms, attacked no national abuses, nor condemned the national enemies. He did not interfere with the authority of those in power. He, who was our example, kept his distance from earthly governments, not because he was indifferent to human woe, but because the remedy did not lie in merely human and external measures. The cure must regenerate the heart. The kingdom of Christ is not established by courts, councils, or legislative assemblies, but by implanting Christ's nature in humanity through the work of the Holy Spirit. Here is the only power that can elevate mankind, and the human agency to accomplish this work is the teaching and practicing of the Word of God. Now, as in Christ's day, the work of God's kingdom does not lie with those who clamor for recognition and support from earthly rulers and human laws. Rather, it lies with those who declare to the people in Christ's name the spiritual truths that produce in the receivers the experience of Paul. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me. Galatians chapter 2.